can still do it. He can still bring water from a rock. He can still part a sea. He can still open blind. Y'all don't believe that. He can still open blinded eyes. And yes, he can even fulfill a promise and get a 90-year-old woman pregnant. Look at somebody and say, it's still possible. And I hear somebody ask the question. They say, is there anything too hard for God? And somebody to shout back at them and say, nothing is too hard for my God. There are many of you under the sound of my voice right now that have found yourself in an uncomfortable position that is draining the life out of you. And it is causing you to lose sleep at night. It's causing you to constantly think in the negative. It's causing you to find tears rolling down your face when you do not even know why. It's because you are living in a place called is there anybody in the house tonight that knows what it's like to want to do better, but no matter how hard you try, you just can't seem to work it out? Does anybody know what it's like to be hit with a low blow of a mystery of iniquity that puts you in disbelief? You cannot believe that this would happen to you. You say, I pay my tithes. I go to church every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. But some reason, God keeps on picking on me. And so you find yourself asking God, why are you messing with me? Let me tell you, it's because you are living in a place called Monday through Saturday. You find yourself cursing God, but when you get to church on Sunday morning, you try to act like everything is all peaches and cream. When Monday through Saturday, you've been cursing God. Now, I want y'all to hear what I really said right here. I did not say Monday through Saturday, you curse. That's not what I said. I said you curse God. And you have to understand that there is a significant difference between cursing and cursing God. All right? You curse God when your supervisor, you curse when your supervisor gets on your nerve. That's cursing. But you curse God when you preach salvation and you live a sinful life. You curse when somebody sits in your favorite seat at church, but you curse God when you say he is not who he says he is. You curse when you stump your toe on the desk, but you curse God when you fully deny the fact that he woke you up this morning, started you on your way, put food on your table, clothes on your back. That's when you curse God. You curse when somebody cuts in front of you on 59, but you curse God. Oh, please be seated. I'm sorry. I really just want to talk today. I need to let you all know here, everybody that's under the sound of my voice, I need you to leave this church today knowing that your God can do anything. Don't you doubt him about not one thing. Let me tell you this. Don't ever doubt my God, because my God has been too good to you. Even though you try to deny the fact that he woke you up, he done paid your bills, he did everything you asked him to do, but you still say there is no God. How dare you, you demon? You better realize how good God has been to you, and you better praise God every chance that you get, because the Bible says no man knows the hour or the day. My God can do anything. My God can seal, he can heal, he can break, he can make. Preach, Scott. My God can prove, he can move, he can walk, he can talk. Preach, Scott. He can reveal, he can conceal, he can expose, he can transpose. Preach, Scott. He can multiply, he can magnify, he can conform, he can transform. Preach, boy. My God can do anything. Look at somebody and say, you better praise my God, because I guarantee you that he can do absolutely. Please be seated. I'm sorry. I really just want to talk tonight. Beloved, I submit to you tonight that there is a place called anything. In this place called anything, can y'all walk with me while I try to paint the picture, please? This place called anything is a twofold place by where nothing is exempt from happening to you. But it is also a place where you can get anything that you want. It's a place where it's a place where divorce goes on spring break, but it's a place where restoration lives. Can you see the place? It's a place where AIDS and HIV have a holiday, but it's a place where that it's the only place where there is a cure found for it. It's a place where children are molested and raped every day. Oh, but it's a place where forgiveness lives. Can you see the place called anything? It's a place where Father fathers leave their families, but it's a place where God shall all of your needs. Can you see the place? It's a place where worry visits, but it's a place where peace lives. I'm trying to see, can you see the place called anything? It's a place where pain and turmoil eats away at your livelihood and hope, but it's a place where God will lift up a standard against it that will let you know that he is there for you. It's a place, oh God, I feel like preaching. Preach then. It's a place where the devil has infiltrated the government, but it's a place where God reveals his glory. I am talking about a place called anything. Please do it for me one more time. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, my God can do absolutely. Preach, boy, if it's the last thing you do. This place. Meeting, we don't got nothing in common. Oh, because I need somebody that's gonna agree with me. Because watch this, I learned my lesson in Genesis with Adam and Eve, because the Bible says that Adam and Eve were in the Garden of Eden, were they not? They were in the Garden of Eden, and the Bible says that Adam went to worship God, right? But he left Eve in the garden. That's why whenever I get married, whoever I marry, you got to be a church lover, because you got to come to church with me, because I can't leave you at the home, because that's when the devil comes in, because the devil will he will always win. Whoever communicates effectively will always be the winner. So if I'm going to church, pack your bags, because we got to go there. If I'm going to a revival, I'm getting your plane ticket too, because I need somebody that will agree with me, because when we agree, thousands will get saved, millions will meet God. Where did that come from? Hallelujah. That sounded all right. I need somebody that will agree with me. Because whenever you agree, I keep telling you that anything is possible. And let me tell you this, ladies. When you understand this place called anything, whenever something hits you, it doesn't even matter. I'm telling you right now, I don't live in Houston, Texas. I live in anything, Texas. Hey, look at somebody and say, neighbor, I don't know where you live, but I live in anything, Texas. That's where I live. Because in Houston, gas is $4 a gallon. But in anything, thou anointest my head with oil. So what other people worrying about, I just use it as grease. In Houston, it's a place where sickness lives. But in anything, by his stripes, I am already healed. In Houston, depression lives there. But in anything, I've got joy, unspeakable joy. In Houston, that's where divorce lives. But in anything, when nothing else could help, love lifted me. And I'm trying to figure out, is there anybody in the house today who's living in a place called anything? But where whatever happens to you, I'll still praise my God, because he's been that good to me. So with no money in the bank, I'll still shout. When everybody gives up on me, I'll still dance. When you turn your back on me, I'll still shout, because I'm living in a place called anything. Slap your neighbor high five and say, you need to move, you need to move, you need to move. Let me tell y'all this. I challenge everybody in here. Matter of fact, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, get on my level. Look. Tell them, upgrade your status. Tell them, upgrade your status. Get you a U-Haul truck. Get you a Penske. You need to move out of Houston and move into anything. Because when you're in anything, nothing matters at all. But in Houston, you feel like giving up. But in anything, I don't care. But in Houston, I'm crying all night long. But in anything,